Κύριος Ανδρέας Δρυμνιώτης, ως σύμβουλος επιχειρήσεων.
Ευχαριστώ πολύ. Θα μιλήσω στα αγγλικά, αλλά θα κάνω μια μικρή εισαγωγή. Όταν μου δόθηκε ο τίτλος της ενότητας, είχα την αίσθηση του déjà vu, διότι όταν ξεκίνησα να δουλεύω με τα κομπιούτερ, είχαμε την ίδια αίσθηση τότε ότι θα υπάρξει πολύ μεγάλη ανεργία, γιατί τα κομπιούτερ θα πάρουν τη δουλειά σχεδόν όλων των ανθρώπων. Βρισκόμαστε ξανά περίπου στην ίδια κατάσταση. I will switch to English now. Let us examine the implications of the new digital age. I will concentrate only on three main issues. The explosion of digital content, the automation of knowledge work, and the massive usage of advanced robotics. According to Eric Schmidt, the executive chairman of Google, quote, "Every 2 days, we create as much digital content as we did from the dawn of civilization until 2003. That's about 5 exabytes of information," end of quotation. I'm not sure that we can fully understand the implications of the magnitude of the digital information. 1 exabyte is a 60th power of 2, or a digital number with 19 digits. And certainly this amount of information is growing. Everybody creates this information, and most of it is practically available to everybody, which is connected to the internet. And, quote again, "the internet is among the few things that humanity has built, that humanity doesn't understand, the largest experiment in anarchy that we have ever had," to quote once again Eric Schmidt. The digital content is valuable, and a lot of agencies and individuals are after it. Just to name a few: governments, scientists, researchers, journalists, activists, laymen, and housewives. The use of the information may be for the improvement of our lives, but also, like everything else, it can be used for evil purposes. Governments might use it the information to violate civil liberties, and columnists to invade the private lives of individuals, just to give you a couple of examples. But there are others, like the terrorists and the criminals, who will use this information in order to facilitate the illegal activities. It is obvious that the first thing we require is security against the misuse of digital content. New skills are required in order to cope with the problem. After a string of high-profile cyber attacks on private sector companies such as Sony and Target, and the highest tiers of the U.S. government, President Obama, in the last year of his presidency, is making a bold statement about the escalation of cyber threats, namely a $90 billion cybersecurity plan that includes the appointment of federal chief information security officer. This is a completely new area of IT, security. Every company, they will need a security officer. According to the CEO of CyberVista, a cybersecurity workforce and development company, there is going to be a serious shortage of cyber workforce. He estimates that by year 2019, there will be in the States approximately 6 million cybersecurity jobs open, but only 4.5 million people are qualified to fill them. Therefore, we have again an opportunity to retrain ourselves in order to cope with that. Another implication of the abundance of information available to practically everybody is the necessity to organize and search this enormous amount of data. I believe that the majority of the connected people will learn to program. In fact, there are people who believe that the basic education must include programming. Definitely, programming is becoming easier as machines become more intelligent, and therefore coding will not be as difficult as it was in the past. The organization www.code.org, established in 2013 with the sole purpose of teaching everybody to learn to code, claims that they have educated to code 216 million people, including President Obama and other celebrities. Now let's come to robots. Today, a confluence of advances in computational speed, machine learning, and natural usage of interfaces has brought computing to an important milestone. Computers are now becoming capable of doing jobs that it was assumed only humans could perform. Computers, for example, can now act on unstructured commands, answering a question posed in plain language, and even make judgments. They can shift through massive amounts of information to discern patterns and relationships. They can learn rules and concepts based on examples or simply by crunching data. And with advanced interfaces and artificial intelligence software, they can understand and interpret human speech, actions, and even intentions from ambiguous commands. In short, computers can increasingly do many of the tasks that are currently performed by knowledgeable workers. To the robots, I'm quoting from McKinsey report on disruptive technologies, and this is a quote. Now, more advanced robots are gaining enhanced senses, dexterity, and intelligence thanks to accelerating achievements in machine vision, artificial intelligence, machine-to-machine communication, sensors, and actuators. These robots can be easier for workers to program and interact. They can be more compact and adaptable, making it possible to deploy them safely alongside workers. This advantage could make it practical to substitute robots for human labor in more manufacturing tasks, as well as in growing number of service jobs, such as cleaning and maintenance. The technology could also enable new types of surgical robots, robotic prosthetics, and exoskeleton braces that can help people with limited mobility to function more normally, helping to improve and extend lives. End of quote.
I would like to inform you that we have,
I have one minute. Time, that's it. The recent progress in artificial intelligence and robotics motivated a number of major corporations in investing billions of dollars in these technologies. Artificial intelligence techniques like machine learning are now routinely used for speech recognition, translation, behavior modeling, robotic control, risk management, and other applications. McKinsey predicts that these technologies will create more than $50 trillion of economic value by 2025. If this prediction is accurate, we should expect dramatic changes in investment soon. By the same token, we need to re-educate our workforce in order to cope with the new environment. I want to leave you with an optimistic note. It is a quotation by John F. Kennedy. Quote, "We believe that if men have the talent to invent new machines that put men out of work, they have the talent to put those men back to work." Of course, Kennedy was referring to the computers at that time, and the common fear that computers would create millions of unemployed people. We have seen that computers have replaced humans in a lot of repetitive activities, but on the other hand, they created more jobs than they have eliminated. I strongly believe that the same thing will happen with artificial intelligence and robotics as long as we re-educate ourselves to the new skills which will be required in the future. Thank you.